Hey, what's up, Duty Games fans? This is THQ Tank, your official WWE Games Community Manager, and we're back with another Inside the Ring, focusing this time on one of our newest features, the WWE 12 comeback moment. And as you can see right here, the five-knuckle shuckle attitude adjustment master himself, Mr. John Cena. Let's just let it ride here for a moment, and I'll introduce you to my partner in crime.
Yeah, John's thinking two for the price of one here. Neither one of you can see me. It's a double you can't see me and a double five-knuckle shuffle.
Boom. Hey, sitting right next to me is one of our lead designers, Mr. Brian Williams. Brian, how you doing, buddy?
I'm doing good, Tank. What's going on, man?
What's going on? So what are we seeing here? We just saw some live-action footage of John Cena from Raw Super Show a couple weeks ago. And now we're seeing it right here in the game. What do we got going on here?
Yeah, this is one of our brand new gameplay features. The I think you just mentioned them. The superstar specific comeback moments. And what it is essentially is just like what you saw in that that opening video there of Cena doing his five moves of doom. We have these implemented this year as comeback moments you can do once you been on the receiving end of a pretty prolonged beatdown.
And I think Cena's getting beat down, but he's about to turn it on right here.
There he goes.
There it is. Five moves into him.
There it goes. So once you trigger these comeback sequences, they're real quick, quick time events where, you know, the first player, the attacker or defender, press the button, gets the advantage. And once you're done, like Cena just hit his successfully, it puts you in position to perform your signature move, which is bam right there. Followed by, I think I'm going to do a little wake up taunt right here. Yeah. Get swagger
up. People are loving that feature, by the way.
Oh, I love the wake up taunts, man. And then attitude adjustment. And sorry, Swagger, you know, but I had to show this off for the masses.
I know you don't like Swagger. Come on, just be honest.
I'm a Swagger fan. Oh, but this
guy.
But
here's your boy. Here's the real guy.
Mr. Daniel Bryan. So glad that he's in the game this year.
And he's kicking Ted DiBiase's. Well, we'll just leave it at that. Tyson Kidd, they always had a feud there, didn't they?
They did. They kind of on and off again. They're always fighting. And Tyson's my boy, too. Shout out to him. He's an awesome wrestler.
So here we're seeing Daniel Bryan's comeback moment.
Boom. And now we're about to see it replicated in WWE. I'm about to say 13.
What do you call that move right there?
What that movie did right there? That was just a running.
I can't say it. The front missile double kick.
No, that wasn't the front drop kick. That was just a running drop kick in the corner.
But we will see it here in the game in a moment.
We will. Boom. Look at that. Look at that dexterity.
Taking out his Nexus arch enemy, Nemesis.
Mr. Wade Barrett.
Wade looks good this year again. Look at those tats, man.
Yeah, he does. He looks pretty good.
Brian looks better.
I think Brian looks awesome. Boom, and he hits him. So it's just like on programming. Does his taunt right there, the fighting spirit. Now, this signature move, he doesn't do it so much in the WWE nowadays, but back when he was in Ring of Honor, he used to do that quite a bit. Can I mention Ring of Honor? Is that okay?
Of course, yeah.
All right, cool. I don't want to get
in trouble. You know the history of these guys better than anybody on the team, just about, I would say, in my opinion. Corey and John might have a little debate with you there, but you know.
Yeah, I mean, I'd like to think that I know my stuff.
You do. Like, here's one of my favorite guys, Kofi Kingston. He's one of the nicest WWE superstars I've ever met. And
look at that reversal. I'm sorry to cut you off. That was
cut
awesome.
Me off anytime you want.
Reversal moment right there. All right, continue. I'm sorry.
No. Well, you know, Kofi, he's actually one of the guys on the roster who's a pro at our game.
He is.
A hardcore video game junkie. And, of course, he's taken out the awesome one here who has become our quote-unquote poster boy, as he'd like to think.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, we should have came out with another version of the game with The Miz on the cover. I mean, for all the pub he's been doing for the game and representing it, he's doing a good job, I got to say.
You hear that, Miz? We got a lot of love for you, buddy.
We do, man, we do. Love The Miz, love The Miz. Love Kofi as well. Uh-oh, this don't look good for The Miz, though. Bam, Trouble in Paradise.
When I get real excited at work, I also do a little Trouble in Paradise. Clap my hands around the office. I do.
Get your taunt on.
Especially when someone says something really good on the boards, or they follow me on Twitter, or they like us on Facebook.
Do you bust that with the boom clap
when
you see that?
I do.
Wow.
I don't want to break everybody's ears on the microphone here. So here's the 619 master, Mr. Rey Mysterio. We are deeply saddened to see him out of action right now, but at the very least, people will get to play him in WWE 12,
of course. That's right.
And they'll get to beat the snot out of Cody Rhodes. The mask.
Yeah, he doesn't have the mask on right here. It's an older clip, but goodness, just the same.
Rey, you know, nobody flies like Rey. Nobody flies like Ray.
You know what? I'd have to agree with you. I mean, I know Sin Cara is all right. He's, you know, he's good, but you know, Ray right now is still holding it down for the Lucha Libre contingent in the WWE.
Of course, of course. You know, a lot of people have been asking to see Sin Cara's entrance, Sin Cara's moves. I know we're going to be we'll be revealing him on the roster soon enough.
Is there a lot of demand for
there
that?
There is
really?
A lot of demand, a lot of excitement. I think people want to see a Sin Cara versus Rey Mysterio match, so we might have to do that in a future Inside the Ring, a little
Lucha
Libre.
Oh, that'd be pretty cool. Yeah. Because I usually when I play the game, I actually, if I'm using Rey Mysterio, I've got Sin Cara in the ring opposing him.
So tell us a little bit more about the comeback moments in terms of how much it can be used or exploited. Is it one of those things that you can only use once in a match, or how does it work?
Yeah, you can, because they are pretty powerful abilities. And they are abilities. I should probably mention that. They're abilities just like, you know, springboard attacks, outside dives, the hammer throw. The comebacks are a new ability to this year's game. So the superstar that has the comeback ability can perform the comeback moment. And you're correct. You can use them once per match because they are pretty, you know, the game changers.
Sure.
You know, so you don't want players being able to perform these sequences, you know, ad nauseum or more than one time in a match. I mean, it's they're used to help get you back in the match once you've been getting your butt kicked, so to speak. So you can only use them once, and you cannot perform a comeback moment if you have a stored finisher icon, just to put some balance on there, so you won't be able to you know, perform a comeback moment and then go ahead and, you know, perform your finish on the guy. Yeah, like they're really reserved for those situations when you're down and out.
You know, speaking of comeback moments, if there's one guy who always comes back, whether it's from the grave or not, it is the Undertaker.
It is, the dead man himself, who's hibernating right now. I guess we'll see him come Royal Rumble time, I guess.
He rose from the grave right there.
Yeah, he does. Oh, poor CM Punk.
Yeah, they
I'm
had
sorry
good,
for
they
all you punk fans out there. I'm just doing this just as an example.
Did have a good running feud on SmackDown. I'm sure CM Punk, more than anybody, would love to get his shot at Taker at Mania sometime in the future. You never know. It could happen. I'd like to see
it. Yeah, you never know. That's one thing about watching or being a fan of the WWE. You never know what the heck's going to happen.
His comeback moment is just vicious.
Yeah, I like it a lot.
Absolutely vicious. So now, when you do the comeback moment, how weakened is your opponent?
Well, weakened enough so that it puts you in position, like I said, to do your signature. So
Sure. Even
if it's performed on somebody who may not have as much damage, they'll at least stay down long enough for you to perform that signature move on them, you know. So it's not going to be a situation where you perform the comeback and your opponent's popping right back on their feet, you know, negating what you've just accomplished.
And I think this is our final comeback moment that we're going to be showing in this video. And there's no better way to end it than with the Viper himself, Mr. Randy Orton, who...
The cover superstar.
The cover superstar. He's getting his butt kicked, but here it comes. Here it comes. He's getting angry.
Sheamus sitting the taunt it right there. Got the ire of the Viper. Oh!
And we're going to show something that's completely new to the game, a move that Orton has that he's become infamous for. You'll see it here in just a second. Oh, taking it to the head.
I think I know what you're talking about.
I think this is it, Brian. I think this is it.
Here he comes.
The ultimate comeback moment. The ultimate finisher.
Goodbye, Sheamus. Bam!
Boom!
Oh, look at that. So beautiful, so beautiful.
We'll see you next time, WWE Games fans. Stay tuned for more Inside the Ring, and be sure to pre-order WWE 12 for The Rock. Like us on Facebook.com/WWE Games, Twitter.com/WWE Games. Check out our website, WWE.THQ.com. Brian Williams.
Who is this? Tank or Zack Ryder, man? You popped that out just like Zach does.
I'm trying. Bravo.